Hell yeah. All right, you guys ready for your next comic? She's super funny. You're gonna love her. Make a lot of noise for Claire Malkie.
How's it going, Laugh Factory? Give it up for all the comics you've seen so far. It's been incredible. And I just want to say thank you to Jerry and the Comedy Gazelle. Like, this is a very cool publication, so definitely check it out. But I do have to tell you guys, so last weekend I was at a wedding for a family friend, and we all have family friends. They're that person you hate, but your dads were friends in the 80s. And so I'm at this wedding, and my cousin is there. And you guys, I cannot stand my cousin, okay? He thinks he's so cool because he was in the Air Force. Okay, I served too. I was in a sorority. You think I wanted to be there? No, I did that for my country, Bachelor Nation. But my cousin, he comes up to me and he's like, hey, Claire, just so you know, we're not gonna like hang out after the wedding because I have a new girlfriend. Okay, just so we're clear, like, I've never hung out with my cousin. I've never even, like, considered hanging out with my cousin. I was like, ew, Kyle, we are not those kinds of white people. But how did you meet her, and is she prettier than me? And he goes, yeah, she's way hotter than you, and we met on Be Real. Excuse me, that is not a dating app. Like, I met my boyfriend the normal way, on Craigslist. But, like, can you imagine meeting your significant other on Be Real? Like, that's disgusting. Like, Be Real is, like, the goodwill of your camera roll. Like the quality of pictures on Be Real, that's, like, it's, like, you know when your dad sends you a text message, but it's just, like, the flash went off while his phone was in his pocket? Yeah, that's Be Real. But my dad and I, we actually don't really text that much. My dad's a little bit more old-fashioned. Anytime my dad wants to get in contact with me, he just picks up my credit card bill. Yeah, so I am an only child. Are there any other only children in the house? Amazing, amazing. Maybe you guys will understand this, but like the worst part about being an only child is having an older brother. But I will say, like, my brother's a lot older than me. You know, he's Gen X, so kind of forgettable. But he is, like, twice my age older than me. Like, my brother's the kind of older than me where, like, I think he might be my real dad. And, like, the thing is, just, like, for context, like, my mom is my brother's stepmom. So, like, you just never know. Yeah. But I'm currently the age where all my friends are married, but I'm actually not married, I'm pro-choice. Yeah. But all my married friends, they always tell me, they say, Claire, don't worry, you're next. And I'm like, that's what serial killers say. Like, I know it's spooky season, but I think I'm good. And whenever I go to these weddings, there's always all this small talk, you know, the best man is like, I just got a promotion. And then the sister of the bride is like, I just bought a condo. And I'm like, well, I just started Wellbutrin. Yeah, thank you. Although, just a little pro tip, you know, from me to you, Wellbutrin doesn't really, like, hit that well at weddings. The wedding planner, she actually overheard me, and she pulled me aside, and she was like, hey, girly, hey, so just so you know, mental health is not on the itinerary today. If you could just keep the conversation to the approved topics, like your recent vacations, or how beautiful the bride is, or when you'll be having babies, that would be great. So I just went and popped Zoloft in the back, and it was great. But I do go to a lot of weddings. I do go to a lot of weddings with my boyfriend. We were actually at a wedding for one of his childhood friends. And I gotta tell you guys, there is something so informative about watching your boyfriend dance with the boys he went through puberty with. Like, there was one point on the dance floor where my boyfriend grabbed his friend's ass. I was like, babe, I thought you said you didn't want to do anal. And then, And then he looked into his friend's eyes and said, "I love you." I was like, "You only say that to me when the Eagles win." You know, it's fine, whatever, go Bears. But my boyfriend is Indian, so we do go to a lot of Indian weddings together. And look, you guys, Indian weddings are, they are so much better than white people weddings. Like, I don't think I can go to another white person wedding. Like, white people weddings are so boring. They're so boring. like if Indian weddings are a party, white people weddings are a funeral. And you know, it's like, why offer me weed when you have cocaine, you know? No, I don't do cocaine, I do crack. No, you think I do crack? Are you kidding me? No, sweetie, no. Like, I don't look like I do crack. I look like I'm your kid's babysitter, but like not the fun one. And it's not even that like your kids don't think I'm fun, it's like you don't think I'm fun. It's a little embarrassing for me, but that's fine. So a lot of the weddings that we go to are on the East Coast. I'm originally from Washington, D.C. Yeah, thank you. Lukewarm response, that's okay. But you know, living in the Midwest, turns out D.C. is like not a normal place to be from. Like apparently most people are from Indiana. But it was really hard to date in D.C. because the guys were so like career focused, you know? Like when I would go out, I would want stability and commitment, and all they would want was to steal the Declaration of Independence. Just like priority issues. But you know, D.C., it can get a bad rap because we had things, you know, like January 6th happen. You know, that was a rough day for me personally because my ex from high school was at the insurrection. So I did turn him into the FBI. Thank you. I also turned in my cousin. He wasn't there, it just seemed like the right thing to do. But for the FBI, for my ex, I said, here's his Twitter handle, and here is every text message he sent me when we were 17. Yeah. He definitely stormed the Capitol on January 6th, 2021, and he definitely was not at Jake's house on July 11th, 2013. And you know, I don't know what's taking the FBI so long. They just need to hire any girl who's listened to Olivia Rodrigo, and this would all be settled. All right, you all have been great. Thanks so much. I'm Claire Malkie.
Claire, give it up for Claire one more time. Oh, yeah.